Welcome. In this video, we'll see the SFRs related to external interrupt. So the first SFR is TCON SFR. So this SFR is again divided into two parts. One part is related to external interrupts and the other part is related to controlling the timers. So in this video, we'll see the part which is used for controlling the external interrupts. So the lower four bits are related to external interrupts. So out of that, IT0 and IT1 bits are related to external interrupt 0 and external interrupt 1 respectively. So the use of this bit is to decide the type of signal that will generate an interrupt. So when this bit is 0, it means that a low level signal on external interrupt 0 will generate an interrupt. Whenever the bit IT0 is equal to 1, it means that a falling edge signal on external interrupt 0 pin will generate an interrupt. Same is the case with external interrupt 1. So this IT1 bit is for external interrupt 1. So when this bit is 0, it means that a low level signal will generate an interrupt on external interrupt 1 pin. Whereas if this bit is 1, then it means that a falling edge signal on external interrupt 1 pin will generate an interrupt. Next bit is IE0 and IE1. So IE is used to identify whether an interrupt has occurred or not. So whenever an external interrupt 0 has occurred, at that time this IE0 bit will become 1 to indicate that external interrupt 0 has occurred. And whenever the program counter jumps to ISR, at that time this bit is automatically cleared by the CPU. IE1 bit is for external interrupt 1. So whenever external interrupt 1 has occurred, at that time this bit becomes 1 to indicate that the interrupt has occurred. And whenever CPU jumps to the ISR, at that time this bit is automatically cleared by the CPU. So this is about the TCON SFR. The remaining part of this SFR will be studied when we study the timers. So here is an example of how the signal can be configured for whether it will be generating an interrupt on falling edge or on low level. So here the IT0 bit is available at LSB position of TCON SFR. So when that bit is 1, it means that a falling edge trigger on interrupt 0 pin will generate an interrupt. Similarly, if that bit is 0, it means that a low level signal will generate an interrupt on external interrupt 0 pin. Next, IT1 bit, if it is 1, then it means that falling edge signal on external interrupt 1 will generate an interrupt. Whenever IT1 bit is 0, it means that a low level signal will generate an interrupt on external interrupt 1 pin. Next SFR is IE SFR. IE SFR stands for Interrupt Enable SFR. So using this SFR, we can enable or disable individual interrupt signals of all the peripherals. So first bit, that is the LSB bit, is EX0. This bit is used for enabling or disabling the external interrupt 0. If this bit is 1, it means that the external interrupt 0 is enabled. And if this bit is 0, then external interrupt 0 is disabled. So when even if the signal occurs, it will not generate an interrupt. Next is ET0. This is related to timer. So again, we'll see this at the time of studying the timers. Next is EX1. Here this bit is again related to external interrupt 1. So whenever this bit is 1, it means that the external interrupt 1 is enabled. And whenever this bit is 0, it means that external interrupt 1 is disabled. And this MSB bit is related to enabling all or disabling all interrupts. So if this bit is 1, it means that all the interrupts which are having individually bits set, those interrupts will be able to generate an interrupt. If this bit is 0, then irrespective of the status of the individual interrupt bits, none of the interrupts will be able to generate an interrupt. So this is used for enabling all interrupts or disabling all the interrupts. So remaining bits again will study at the time of studying that particular peripheral. So we can enable or disable the interrupts by two methods. First method is by bit operation. This is generally done whenever the program is being executed. So it is recommended in the middle of the execution of program. So that can be done with the help of such kind of instructions. For example, set BEA. So this will enable all the interrupts. Set BET 0. This will enable the timer 0 overflow interrupt and so on. So using a individual bit manipulation instructions, we can enable or disable a particular interrupt. Then another way is to use move instruction. So such kind of technique is generally recommended at the beginning of the program. So for example, we can have an instruction like move IE comma hash 10010110B. So this is again this binary value that is transferred to IE SFR. So with that, the particular interrupts will be enabled and some of the interrupts will be disabled. So all the interrupts that are available in 8051 are having specific priorities. So what if two interrupt sources occur at the same time? Then at that time, the interrupt which is having the highest priority, that will get service from the CPU, whereas the other interrupt will be discarded. So on reset, the default priority available for interrupts is as follows. So first one is external interrupt 0, which is having the highest priority, then timer 0 overflow, then external interrupt 1, then timer 1 overflow, and finally we have serial communication interrupt. So this is the default priority. If we require, then we can change this default priority order. To change that order, we have to use another SFR called as IP SFR or interrupt priority SFR. So this is the format for interrupt priority SFR. In this, all these bits are related to individual interrupts. So this LSB bit is related to external interrupt 0. Next bit is related to timer 0 overflow. Then we have external interrupt 1, then timer 1 overflow and serial communication. So whenever we want to change the priority, we have to make a particular bit equal to 1. So that interrupt will be having the highest priority. So in the next slide, we'll see the example. So here move IP comma hash 0000100B. This data is transferred to IP register. So with that, this one will come over here, that is the 001. So this PX1, this is related to external interrupt 1. So that is having bit 1 and others are having 0. It means that this is having the highest priority. So this will be shifted to the first, that is external interrupt 1. And after that, the default priority will be followed. So the next highest priority will be given to external interrupt 0, then timer 0, timer 1 and serial. So this is the remaining interrupts are having the default priority. The next example is move IP hash 0001100B. So with this, again, this 11 will appear over here, that is 0011. So again, these two bits are now 1. So out of this, again, in default priority will be checked. If more than one bit is set in IP SFR, at that time again the default priority will be checked, and in that the interrupt which is having highest priority, that will be given the highest priority. So here now these two bits are made 1. So again in default priority, external interrupt 1 is having highest priority, so this will be given first priority, then this will be given the second priority, and after that the default priority order will be followed. So next interrupt will be external interrupt 0, then timer 0, and then we have serial. So this is the priority. So this is about the SFRs that are used for controlling the external interrupts. In the next video, we'll see the timer peripheral available in 8051. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.